Oh my goodness. Look at all those iron skillets.
What could we going to do? Let's find out.
Okay. So, if you've watched some of my other videos recently, you'll saw that I made two different rubs. A Mardi Gras, and then a hot, spicy rub. And of course, we're going to be putting those on chicken wings. Yes, I'm going to be doing chicken wings another way. Now, we've got about 4 pounds of wings. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to parboil them for 8 minutes. Then I'm going to take them out and let them drain for about 5 minutes. Then I'm going to give them a gentle massage of some olive oil. After I've massaged them with the olive oil, then I'm going to give them a gentle massage with those rubs. So stay tuned. We're going to be moving really fast. All right, I got my water boiling. I got my pan here ready to drip dry them. And so, let's get them started. All right. Let's put them in. There they go. Let's put a timer on that. Let me get them all broken up. And we'll let them boil for 8 minutes. We will be back shortly. All right, we still got those parboiling. Got about 2 or 3 more minutes on it. And then we'll drain them, and then we'll put them on the rack and let them dry for 5 minutes. Be back soon. Okay, our parboil is done. We're gonna take them over. We're gonna pour them and drain them. All right, let's come take a look at that. There they are. Gonna let them drain for just a second and then transfer them to the pan. Gonna go right there. Be back shortly. Okay, here they come. Get them spread out. I've got some paper towel under that. And this is a large size sheet pan, not a half, but a full. So we got those out. Let's give them a time, 5 minutes. The clock is on. Be back soon. Okay, they have drip dried for 5 minutes. Now I'm gonna drizzle a little bit of olive oil on them and give them a massage with the olive oil. Then next will be the rub. And next, they'll go into the pans. So, let's see how it goes. Okay, got them over here on top of those frying pans. And now I'm just gonna drizzle just a little bit of olive oil over each one of them. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna massage that olive oil all the way around those. And what that's gonna do, that's gonna, number one, it's gonna help my rub adhere, but then also that's going to help them to crisp up. So let's give it just a little bit more, make sure that we've got enough on there. for each one. Okay, so let's massage one and see how that goes. So I'm just going to take that olive oil and massage it all the way around. And yes, I know this seems to be very tedious, but I'm going to tell you, these are going to be delicious. Okay, all right, I got those massaged. So I've got them divided into about equal parts. So the first one is going to be my Mardi Gras rub. That is, if I can get it open. So I'm just going to take it and I'm going to sprinkle it all over. Oh, it smells delicious. I'm going to give it a good coating because I'm going to take these and then I'm going to take that rub and move it all the way around it. Okay, I'm going to do a few and then we'll be right back. Oh yeah. Okay, so what I realized is I can just go ahead and just sprinkle it on there instead of rubbing it. So I don't really have to give it another second massage because I got enough rub to do the whole thing. Mmm, smells absolutely delicious. Can't wait to taste them. Let's get that good and that rub all over them. And in just a second. All right, that one is good to go. And now, let's spread out this other section. And now we're gonna put on the hot and spicy. Here we go. This spreads on a little bit differently. Now remember, we're going to put these in the oven at 450 degrees and we're going to bake them for about 20 minutes. Then I'm going to turn them over and give them a quick 5 minutes. So now I'm going to go ahead and start transferring these into the pans. This is the hotter rub. I believe this new 15-inch Lodge skillet is going to handle 24, approximately 24. It's already got a little bit of olive oil in it, so we're not going to do anything with that. Now I'm going to go ahead, put these others in these other pans, and we'll be ready to bake. So, just to give you a view, there they are, all seasoned, massaged, and ready to go. Be back soon when I'm getting ready to put them in the oven. Okay, my oven went off for 450, so I'm going to open her up, put them in. Here goes that big 15-inch pan. That's going to take up one shelf by itself. Then we got a 12-inch. And another 10-inch. Those are on for 20 minutes. And as usual, set a timer. We'll be back in 20 minutes. As I've told you earlier, I wish you could smell through that foam. Or the camera, I guess I should say. We still got a few more minutes before we rotate them. All right. we've got that 20 minutes up, and now I'm flipping them to get them on the side, the underside, and then I'm going to put them back in. For about 5 more minutes. Those are looking delicious. Let's get that one flipped. All right. We're ready to go back in.
Let's do it.
Okay, so I'm going to give you a little bit of tip here. The timer is about to go off, and when that I do that and I open the oven, I'm going to pull out the first pan, and what I want to see is when I shake them, they move. Did you see that? That means they're done. So let's try the next one. Give her a shake. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. All righty. We'll be back shortly.
Oh, my goodness. What could those be? Stay tuned.
Action. All right, so we got those wings ready. We've got the hot flavored over here. The Mardi Gras, and along with it, we have a spinach artichoke dip and some homemade blue cheese dip on the other side. So, let's give these hot ones a taste. And let's get a Mardi Gras as well. So, let's give them a taste. A little bit of crunch there. Look how it pulls off the bone. I will tell you about this one. It is spicy. Get that little crust. Am I supposed to lick my fingers? All right. Let's try the Mardi Gras. Great flavor, great smell. Got a little char on it. Pulls off the bone real easy. My goodness. Look at that. Wings, another way. We need to try the blue cheese dip. What do you think? Let's try it. Well, as usual, I'm hungry. Let's eat. I'll see you on down the trail.